Ukisikia tu mtu yako amepotea, hebu kimbia Yala hapa. Kimbia tu Yala hapa.
A sad reality that people living along River Yala, Siaya County have been accustomed to. The river which traverses Gem and Bondo sub-counties as it feeds into Lake Victoria has turned into a dumping yard for bodies, mostly in the wee hours of the night, according to residents.
Kama juzi, kuanzia mwezi wa saba, paka jana, kazi yangu ni kutoa tu mwili yenye aina wenyewe. Inaletwa na gari na inamwagwa kwa ile kabriji ya kuenda Busia Kisumu. Zingine zinabakia hapo, zingine zinateremuka mpaka falls, zingine zinaingia intake hapa. Yote hata Jumapili nilitoa mwili hapa.
Human rights defenders claim that they got a distress call from the locals in the area after two more bodies were spotted floating in the river.
So far, we have visited the mortuary. We have seen for ourselves bodies tied with ropes, bodies that have been severely tortured, some of them with dismembered limbs and others with marks on their heads. This signifies that these individuals were tortured before being dumped into the river.
This comes as cases of disappearance have been witnessed in the country. According to a report by Missing Voices 2021, the report indicated that 169 cases of extrajudicial killings were reported in the country and 32 cases of enforced disappearances in Kenya.
What we know is that there is a double cabin and a probox that have been spotted on different dates, individuals dumping bodies or at the bridge into River Yala. According to local communities, this happens in the dead of the night between 1 a.m. and 5 a.m. and they've been spotted several times doing that.
Painting a grim picture for the families who have not seen their loved ones for long. The notorious points along the river where most bodies are found are Ndanu Forest and Dawa Bridge, as all fingers are now pointed to the relevant security agencies in the country to contain the issue.
Today, with our own naked eyes, we have seen floating bodies on River Yala. And the question we are asking, do we have a government in place? How come this is happening in an area that is supposed to have a police station, where we have DCI, where we have a county government, and things are happening in, you know, with everyone's knowledge? How come these vehicles that are dumping bodies have never been caught? The individuals who are doing this, how come they remain unknown?
What we have realized by coming to Yala today is that the human life or the lives of Kenyans has no value at all, because what you saw on this river are bodies that haven't been removed. The police appear to do such work, and it's been done by a citizen. This man, where are the police? Why are they being paid if this is the man who's doing their job? So tunaomba serikali iwajibike, ifanye kazi yao, na wale ambao wako pale ni watu ambao wanajulikana, kwa sababu kila mtu ambaye yuko kwa hii nchi hii ako na fingerprints. So register of persons, kuja chukua fingerprints, enda kwa database, angalia ni akina nani.
Abdi Zizashim, Ibru TV.